think this exists, but it's not exactly what you think.
Well,
it is.
No, so there's a ring at the base of your cock which holds up the cage. But, the magnetic cage.
But the whole cage that sterilizes. The whole cage around the cock thing, I think that's a thing.
No, it is. Yeah. But we're talking just a balls cage. A magnetic balls cage.
Yeah. Oh, it just holds your balls. Okay.
Just holds your balls and magnetizes.
It just constantly sterilizes you.
Yeah, and it wipes the data clean off of them. Like, like
a how does it stay in place around the balls?
The ring.
Well, how do you use the ring?
They're kind of loose. Is it like.
Like a bra for my balls.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
My balls. Well, kind
of like, yeah.
Well, you can get one to where what it is they like roughly size it, they put it up, and then they fit it. So it just kind of like, it doesn't, you know, pierce the skin, but it's in there. So it's just holding itself in place.
Okay.
They take like a little tool and they just like.
That's a good idea.
Crimp it. Magnetic ball cage.
Why don't you just make the lock magnetic so that it's just more magnet?
An alternative. You actually make an incision. They cut your balls open. They place a magnet on the inside. They sew it up. And then they put the cage on the outside. And the magnet inside keeps the cage on the outside in place.
Well, if I
didn't have enough money to buy this, would it also work for me to stick a little tiny magnet inside the tip of my dick?
It's like you're
sounding yourself with a magnet.
A sounding magnet.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah, it's a sounding rod.
What the fuck?
You put it in your urethra.
Jesus.
I was more thinking like maybe you get like a little like circle and it kind of like it's cut open and it's hinged on one side and it closes itself on the other, but then also,
oh, I guess that makes sense.
Yeah,
it's like a traditional prison cage kind of thing.
Yeah, it's like handcuffs, but for your dick.
Yeah.
But the cuff is magnetic.
Yeah.
And then you have more magnet. And then you also kind of make it so that it can be, like, moved inside of itself. So the longer it's exposed to the magnets, the tighter it's going to get.
See, people say things like male birth control doesn't exist, but we've figured it out.
It's not even male birth control. It's, like, just. You blew balls yourself so hard, you don't have balls.
I still have no idea why that's a fetish.
Blue balls?
Like, putting your dick in a cage.
Oh.
Being, like, humiliated.
I was gonna say, you.
Well, I guess the humiliation I can kind of get.
Because you're here with the edge master.
God damn it.
Connor goes weeks.
You might know him by
He's edging right now! Holy shit!
You might know him by his real name, Maverick Edgelord.
When is Arizona Mills closed?
Nine.
Fuck!
Why?
My night is ruined. I wanted that great watermelon juice.
Watermelon juice at the mall?
Oh, yeah. No, it's the best fresh juice
is it from,
in
like,
the world.
Pretzels or
no.
Something?
No, it's.
Like, it's this specialty juice
place?
No.
No, 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 no. It's like the Honeycomb store.
Oh.
But not shitty. No, it is fucking amazing. I'm so sad I'm gonna miss it tonight.
Yeah,
9
o'clock, baby.
Fuck, alright. Well,
we have 20 minutes, so if we really want to, we can burn all this out in 15.
It takes. Yeah, yes. The mall's only 5 minutes away.
Aww.
So let's put 45 minutes of content together in the next 5 minutes
so that we
can make it to the mall and
get
watermelon juice.
My night is ruined. Alright, welcome to the Moisty Voice episode
6.0. 6.0.
In any case.
Oh, well, look at
that. I am Connor.
I am Nick.
My name's Miggle.
And our guest this week
is Logan. Woohoo!
You may recognize him from our Overcooked video, unless that comes out after this, in which case you will then have recognized him from this video.
We don't have a good release timetable. We are.
Oh, yeah.
Although I think I figured it out kind of near the end.
Time travel is great.
We're playing the Swapper again.
This time it's me.
What they don't quite know is that Overcooked is actually going to be like in the middle of this video.
We're just going to stop, start a completely different video, come back to this.
I'm just going to cut it. It's going to then open up into Overcooked.
The people who are listening rather than watching are going to be confused as shit because all of a sudden we're screaming in a kitchen.
Yeah.
Oh no!
Holy shit!
Burning!
Get the fuck out of the way! Holy shit! Why would you do that? No! You fucking idiot!
No, but the audio is going to continue for both.
Okay, you could just focus on one. Play one in one ear. And the other and the other.
I'll split the mono.
Yeah.
Hear a stereo.
Hear a whole cacophony of all of our voices.
Yeah. But, so,
Today we're back.
That's the ideal way to listen to us, by the way. Make sure you do that.
Which I forgot how to play, so...
You want me to?
No.
He's got it.
Pew, pew, pew.
That's the swapping button?
Okay, hold on, hold on.
We know what it is.
Okay, got it. I figured it out.
You got it.
I don't.
Woohoo. It's a puzzle game. You create clones and you kill your clones to get further.
I watched the video on Steam.
You'll figure it out.
So I kind of understand it.
Yeah.
All right.
First up, nice. We are going to go another 97 years of MoistyVoice until we get that sweet, sweet Szechuan sauce.
Szechuan.
Nine more seasons.
97 years, whichever, just get us a Szechuan sauce, which might be coming back.
Yeah, so I'm sure everybody's been following this long enough now, but I guess Dan Harmon, like, twittered...
Dan Harmon, the creator of Rick and Morty, yeah, one of them.
He twittered out to McDonald's, like, you want to get in on this? And they responded with the very painfully awkward...
McNugga-lubba-dub-dub?
Something like it.
Oh my god.
It was very, very painful. But a spokesperson has since said that they are not opposed to bringing it back, depending on demand.
Well, one guy said, I'll have to talk to the corporate chef.
How do we know?
And then the corporate chef twittered out, we'll see what we can do.
How do we know that McDonald's didn't actually pay them to do this?
I very much doubt that the creators of Rick and Morty got that out.
Yeah, probably not.
I very much doubt that this was even a thing until moments before the show aired.
They're like, wait, you guys... know it would be a great bit to add in? And then they just...
This guy's
and then
just
they
sitting
recorded
there,
all of these just... lines with Nathan Fillion last moment.
Yeah, they're just sitting there like, you know, I really wish that I had some Szechuan sauce. And someone just looked at him like, the fuck are you talking about? And that rant happened. That rant happened.
Pretty sure this was hard pre-planned.
Okay.
I think Dan Harmon and
Justin Rowland.
Justin probably had this going for a while. I mean, season 3's been in the works for how long?
7 years?
Yep.
100 years?
I don't know.
But, yeah, no, so
those
I think...
didn't release it already.
So we were all alive around the time of it.
Yeah.
We were
young as hell, but I don't remember it. I don't even remember the promotion, honestly.
From what I've heard about it, actually, it's not even that good a sauce.
What?
Some of us have grown crazy.
I mean, Szechuan like... sauce isn't really that good.
Right.
And McDonald's
how dare you?
Is McDonald's, so... Okay, Logan but, is now the defender of
back,
the Szechuan sauce.
You know, it's... You gotta do it for Rick. Regardless of if it's good or not. I'm excited. I would like to see this show bring back
spooky
something that stupid.
Fun fact that I learned
it would be
out of
cool
this,
to know that that, many, that it's that popular of a show.
One person talked mm-hmm. about, like, oh... you know, Rick and Morty, or not Rick and Morty, McDonald's really needs some success with the, like, 18 to 35 crowd.
Oh,
apparently,
yeah.
Only one in five 18 to 35-year-olds has ever had a Big Mac.
I've never had a Big Mac.
I go to McDonald's, well, actually, I understand, hey, Big Mac's their meal, but if I'm going for an actual, like, burger meal... McDonald's isn't my place. I go to McDonald's for the dollar menu.
I go there wait, for the McNuggets.
Right.
I don't really get anything else there. So
you just killed.
If I
two
want a burger, I'll go to Culver's or Red Robin. I won't go to McDonald's.
Or back when I used to work at a store and there's a McDonald's right across the street, I would actually just go next door to the Carl's Jr. because they had a $4 deal for a cheeseburger, a chicken sandwich, fries, and a drink.
I remember
at
the that,
low,
yeah.
low cost of no. an hour of your fucking time.
They've actually sped it up.
It was the worst
wait,
to ever to...
Wait.
Just, they had no idea what they were doing there.
No, no clue.
Miserable fucking Carl's Jr.
Very bad. But, I mean, so some of the Szechuan sauce has been selling... Right now the bid is, what, $95,000?
I think the highest I've seen is, yeah, $95,000 sauce. On the market for some godforsaken reason.
Oh, your guy in the...
Why?
Hey, man, hype will sell anything.
You know what it won't sell?
Trump.
Jesus. I was gonna sell...
Just kidding. He got memed into existence.
I was gonna say Jesus.
Hype can definitely sell. Bible is the number one selling
well,
book
he did,
ever.
I mean... Didn't
really?
Hype? Didn't
yes.
hype save all of us?
Yeah, every single
isn't
year
that
the
whole
the
foundation of the Christianity
number one best-selling book since the dawn of time, I'm pretty sure.
Christians were capitalists better than, like, any other religion.
Wait, where are you going?
Trump ain't got shit on Christians.
Except maybe Scientology. I'm pretty sure they work around...
They work
They don't sell books. They sell novels. They sell, I don't know.
Salvation.
Tomes?
Yes, tomes.
Tomes are books.
Rip.
Tomes are, like... Yeah, tomes are books.
They're books.
Tomes are old.
I don't
old
got shit on that.
God damn it.
Ain't got
with,
shit
like,
on
the
that.
E after everything.
I still write like that sometimes, and I have no justification for why.
Just... You sometimes include...
I sometimes put an E at the end of a word that it could have an E on, but it doesn't. And I never understood why I did it.
Huh.
Stop like what?
It's probably the faulty AI in my head. That Elon Musk gave me.
Haha.
Yeah, so, like...
Someone's got a little bit too much hard-on for Ghost in the Shell.
Interesting.
He does. Know. No, I'm he just, does.
Like, what... What does he want to do the do for? Is what I don't understand.
Elon Musk doesn't do it for any reason other wouldn't that be cool?
He has actually never done something other than this is a good idea.
Doesn't the world need somebody like him?
He might be a superhero.
Well, we do.
He is a superhero.
He is no. He's one step away from supervillain.
Yeah. No.
Wait.
Elon
what?
Musk is
you
a
solved
dangerous.
The puzzle.
Oh yeah. Okay. You just have to make another person.
A dangerous person.
Wait. Are you out of clones?
So just run to the left.
I don't think that's gonna be the solution, is it?
Was it Neuralink? He just bought this. He's like, I don't know if he bought it. He's privately funding it, but they're like putting robots in your brain.
They want to.
That's one way to say it.
Like, for no particular reason. One because it's cool.
I don't know. A human AI interface is cool. Having it in your head is less so, in my opinion. Not a fan.
Not a fan of...
Not a fan. I don't need that shit
in
my head.
I'm not a fan until computers are more secure.
That's a good point.
Yeah, no, that's actually the biggest concern, is the lack of security.
The day when someone can hack your balls... And, like, decide to turn your semen off?
Yeah, they're gonna hack my magnetic ball bra, and they're going to re-enable all my semen, and I'm going to sire, like, no kids, because, you know, obviously I'm not having sex as it is, but were I, I'd be fucked.
If I was layable, I would have so many problems. Yeah, no, I don't know. It's interesting. It's weird. I just don't get
Wait,
what they're
can,
going for. They
talk
about...
So they want to connect human brains directly to a computer...
Brain damage stuff or something?
For...
What's the potential with this technology besides for funsies?
Potential is all the science fiction shit you've ever seen. Like, Ghost in the Shell precisely. A lot of the things in there potentially is what could be done here. Not that it is likely to, but potentially that is definitely on the table.
I don't know if I want Ghost in the Shell.
I do not.
No.
That because of how insecure it is.
Is it because of how insecure it is, or because of how insecure you is?
Both. The technology at this...
It's because of how insecure everybody
is. Near future does not provide security. There's no safe way to do it.
You can't just trust everybody to not, like,
to not
hack
your brain
and do awful things.
Right.
In a perfect world, you could just be like, hey, Bill, don't hack my brain. And Bill would be like, sure thing, friend.
But yeah, the greatest if here is the greatest if here is the actual extent to what this would enable. Because until we do it, we don't know precisely what all we can do with our brains connected to a computer.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest jump right now is just being able to do it.
So it's like, get the technology... Connect brains to robots.
Then figure out what to do with it.
Then see what fun can be had.
Yes.
I can dig it.
That
Elon
aspect.
Musk is funding it, so that gives me confidence.
I trust Elon Musk for now. I don't think this is the thing that's going to turn him evil. It might be two more projects down the line.
But
so
he
this
will
one's
become
probably
a supervillain
safe. Oh, yeah.
Soon.
Yes.
The problem's going to be...
Guaranteed.
He's just going to... run out of, like, I don't know what project to do next, so I kind of just decided I'm done with knowledge.
He's never gonna find a not project to do.
I'm done with knowledge. I'm moving on to body horror. It intrigues me.
No, he's moving on to Lamborghinis. But yeah, the greatest potential that people are seeing right now is brain damage. Being able to connect with a computer despite having a damaged brain is it's a pretty good pro that will help enable a lot of people. So, I mean, I guess there's a good reason to do it. I don't know.
There are good reasons to do it. There are bad reasons to do it. There are
a lot of bad reasons.
Yeah, good reasons is weaponizing abuse. Too.
I do kind of want to weaponize brains.
We can make super soldiers. That'll be cool.
I don't think an AI would do that. I think that an AI would be more like a Pathfinder from Mass Effect Andromeda.
I entirely disagree.
That AI
not no, so not it'd be closer to that.
That AI was designed AI entirely really... to cripple itself to have compassion.
I'm not talking so much about its use. I'm talking more about its interface. I think they would be kept separate from the body, just you having the ability to tap into it.
Yeah, that's it. We can't put an AI in our head. It's about putting in interfaces in our head to be able to link to exterior things.
Yes.
Well, you could put an AI in your head, but that wouldn't be...
Maybe way down the line?
That's something that I think they said in the article. It's like they were going to try and connect it, but it's really a lot more difficult to know where to do the interface for very specific things.
Yeah. So what is, like, they mentioned that a lot, like, connect to the AI. Is that, like...
You wouldn't necessarily have to connect to an AI.
Smart to your Google Home
so
with
it's,
your thought?
It's going to be a long time before anyone's brain can be plugged directly into a computer.
Mm-hmm.
It's, like, that obviously is one of the goals here, but that's way down the line is actually connecting. So I assume the end goal is, yeah, to have implants in your head that allow you to remotely connect with an interface with your devices,
mm-hmm.
which would be nice, would be helpful to just, you know, mentally be able to control your surroundings. That's an ease of access that we don't yet have.
Mm-hmm.
Is it necessary? God, no. Is it dope as fuck? Yeah.
I preferred it to be more like, rather than an implant where you connect directly, where it's basically you can speak to an Alexa, basically.
I don't want to be talking to a robot in my head.
Head robot?
But if you're going to be interfacing with it anyway, you're going to have to.
No. It does not need to be AI. Yeah, and we don't use AI right now to do all of our stuff. We use AI simply for convenience of ordering dildos off of fucking Amazon.
There are artificial intelligence for all sorts of things. There's, like, general intelligence.
There's a lot of AI.
The general intelligence stuff is kind of still in the works for the most part.
But AI won't be necessary for what this will be.
On the way. Yeah,
I sure as hell won't be connected.
You definitely don't need AI to do it. It's not... It's just kind of a related thing. You can do AI.
Yes, it's definitely related and goes almost hand in hand. That's just much further down the line than even getting this. I don't think that's step 2. I think that's step 18 once we can actually get this handled.
I don't know. I think we might see them come at similar times. Like, because we're working on general AI right now.
And we're working on... There are
not
what,
that I'm
two
working
or three
on
big
I would love to be working on it.
AI projects. Not that I like. There are definitely a lot of uses and pros to AI. Obviously, I can't say elsewise. Are there risks with directly interfacing with one? In my opinion, the risk is unfathomable.
My question is more like, what's the reward right now? What's the payoff?
Right now?
Because all I see is being able to connect to, like, your Ari. Or not Ari. Your Amazon Alexa. Or your
Siri?
You know, Google Home or Siri. Like, because there's really no AI anywhere outside of these things.
I think
yes.
people have
like,
no idea what AI is going
to
be like
phone.
At this point.
Yeah, it's like, it's not
once
there
people...
yet.
once we get like more advanced in having like general intelligence AI that can do anything that a human can, basically, just maybe not necessarily as good, but maybe generally robots do a lot of things better, obviously. But we've yet to see what they're really capable of.
Would we be
what they're really
to,
gonna
like,
be like?
Mind control robots.
Well, yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm sure
I'd
if
love
we're
to
still
be in like three places at once.
I know.
Oh, that,
I
oh like, no, like taking control
no.
of a,
the human
a robotic
brain
body.
Would not
oh
be able
God.
To handle that.
That's too much information.
I want
TMI.
To mind
oh my God.
Across the world with some robot and like be doing people. Two
you
people at once.
Not, I don't think you could do two people at once, but if you
dude,
could...
Dude, two chicks at the same time!
I think, yeah, down the line, you could definitely enter a stasis kind of form with your physical body to be able to mentally, electronically interlink with a separate body elsewhere. I think that's definitely something doable.
I guess my question is more, can I connect... So I've got me.
Okay.
I've got a lady robot.
Okay.
I brain connect to the lady robot.
Yes.
So that in two directionally, I am fucking myself when I fuck the lady robot.
You
I'm
will so have an aneurysm.
That my brain is in.
You will actually have an aneurysm and die.
I want to fuck myself while I fuck myself.
Do not fuck yourself.
I think that's really where this technology is headed.
But for any of that, also we've got to then step all prosthetic and cybernetic advances years ahead because you need to be able to actually be able to work that body.
We can't.
It needs to be responsive. You need to feel. You need to... So for what you're saying, it's not only this, but like five other sciences that need to progress further another 20, 30 years.
So basically what you're wanting, the easiest way to do it would basically make a whole bunch of VR shit.
No, man, that's not the same.
Just wait for it. Okay. So we make a whole bunch of VR shit, then we sit you down in a bed,
okay,
and we completely disassociate you from your body.
So like a sensory deprivation tank?
Basically.
Okay.
And then we upload your consciousness into three different bodies. So you know how the Sony tech has, you can see from three different perspectives?
Yeah.
Do something like that.
Self orgy.
That's not. That's you know, not if, you wanna, if you want to, if you want to fucking fuck yourself, if you want to like,
I want to have an orgy
lay
with myself
in a circle
with three
and just jerk each other off. You can.
I don't think we can handle that.
You don't think you can handle circle jerk?
Not the. I cannot handle the circle jerk. It is too much circle, not enough jerk.
I don't know. Yeah.
I was just my entire
right,
thing
though,
is I was loading
I
up to the circle
halfway
jerk.
Through. You're gonna just like have
your
a
brain's
nose
just
bleed,
yeah.
And then your
you're
eyes
have
are
a
gonna bleed,
and then like the sensation of jerking off like four times in unison is gonna overload you. And you'll come too fast.
It's
you'll
gonna
really
feel
get to
you
too.
You could probably handle like not two different perspectives, but two dicks. You could probably handle feeling both of those. I think pushing more is too much. I don't think you can handle four dicks. I think that's.
You don't think I can handle four. Let me tell you about my weekend in Cabo.
I would rather you didn't.
Boy, I wish you wouldn't.
Boy, could I handle four dicks then.
That is the worst.
Oh.
I don't know. But that's all technology that's so far ahead. We aren't even good with the technology we have now. The Nintendo Switch, which released March 3rd,
yeah.
March 3rd, so a month ago.
It's harder than I thought.
Oh, yeah.
It's 2017. We have PS4.5 out, Xbox 1.5 on the way. So we're
it's
like.
It's out the S.
No, it's Scorpio.
Oh, yeah.
The S is not the
stupid
PS4
shit.
Pro camera.
I thought it was
guys,
for the longest
no,
time.
It's
I do not
slim.
Understand how you.
It's the
yeah.
Xbox One Slim with
just
a 1
slim.
Terabyte hard drive.
It's just dumb. Why would you do that?
That's what they. That's every generation.
So we got these.
So we. The Switch is, it's 2017, we've got a bunch of other, you know,
yeah.
top-of-the-line consoles out that don't have all these problems. Nintendo releases this new console, and they're warping in their charging stations. They're made so shoddily that they're actually destroying themselves by being idle.
They're like you.
I've got nothing, no, that, yeah, no, yeah. You got me. I'm sad, but you got me.
No, yeah, I just... Where did it go wrong with Nintendo is my question. Was it they got too greedy and they decided to pump out too many too fast?
Like they're still not connected. They are still 10 years behind, despite all of their claims elsewise.
One of these days, they'll catch up to, like, 2008 Sony.
Maybe.
It's just, I don't know. It's rough. So, yeah. I want a Switch. Yeah, I meant to spawn. There's so many problems with the Switch, though. Aside from physical
problems, it's 2017. 4K TVs in 6 months are the new standard.
Yeah.
The Switch has a 720p screen.
Wow.
Does it?
Yeah. I didn't know that. It's not even 1080.
I forgot.
That's awful.
That's how bad it is.
But like,
well, Nintendo isn't known for being the most free to
that's why they keep making mistakes
to fuck themselves over. Yeah, the dock scratches the screen, so they had to go and release.
You need
their
to if you buy a Switch, you don't even want to use it until you buy a hard screen protector. Otherwise, you're going to harm it.
And now the dock is designed to overheat it, bends and warps it.
They had such potential. I personally, the console that you can pick up and bring with you wherever you go, I love that idea.
Yeah.
And the 3DS was cool, but it was, you know, a 3DS. It couldn't do console stuff.
I thought they had figured, you know, I was telling people, it's more a portable than a console.
Right.
And what does Nintendo do best?
Portables. Portable.
Yeah.
They're not going to fuck this up. And boy, golly.
They sure let us down.
Boy, golly, they screwed it up.
I'm with you. I definitely want to pick one up down the line, because the new Zelda is a fantastic game.
I don't want to
play that shit on Wii U.
Fuck that.
Wii U was...
I want to play it on a real system, but right now there isn't one.
There is not
one. My options are Wii U and the Switch, neither of which I want to be doing right now.
Yeah.
I honestly would probably rather, like, emulate it on some really jank-ass computer software.
Speaking of emulators,
there's an emulator for...
Windows Store has banned all game emulators from their App Store.
Wow.
Wow.
Yeah.
Who downloaded them from the App Store, though?
Or from the, like, you know, Windows phones and stuff?
Yeah.
You can no longer have...
Shit,
yeah,
that's true. For
no more emulators.
Wow. So much for
is
Pokemon
that good or bad?
Players.
It's, you know, it's bad for a lot of people that used them. But it's... depending on your stance on emulators and taking paid content, making it free, it's good. Because emulating is technically pirating.
Well, Sony made a PS2 emulator with the
inside the
PS3.
It's
that's
Sony.
Different.
Yeah,
Sony made that. That's,
they can make their own.
Yeah, no, that's not even.
He's
this
talking
is
about
third-party
like,
emulators on Microsoft Store that are like hosting old Nintendo games and shit.
Yeah,
which
basically
is
Pokemon more times than
yeah.
Not.
Right. Okay.
I think the Pokemon Red and Blue emulators are the most popular of them all.
Yeah,
but I'm fine with it so long as there isn't like another current medium to play it. But they just released Red and Blue on the 3DS,
so now it is pirating.
Yeah.
Well, it was pirating before.
Well, could you really say that it's stealing from Nintendo's profit if the only way to get the game is from
pirating
game
isn't
stores?
Just about stealing from profit, though.
No, I'm saying, though, like you mentioned that, you know...
It's not stealing,
it's
though.
Not stealing from Nintendo...
It's copying.
...if Nintendo isn't selling it anyway.
Like, what if you don't want to buy the console and you just want to play the game?
Like, if I
want
to play Red, I go get a Game Boy Advance or a DS, which... You know, or I guess a no DS couldn't play Red.
It could no.
Only, yeah, so Game Boy Advanced or older, which Nintendo is not making money off of. I buy a copy of Red or Blue.
The
Nintendo's
not making,
money
off of
money. Off of
no,
it.
No, no, no. The DSi is still selling. In the DSi,
it
still
could play Game Boy Color games.
Yeah, it can.
Could it?
Yeah.
Son of a bitch.
It had a Game Boy SP in it. Like it basically had a Game Boy SP emulator in it. You just have to throw it in there. And the DSi still sells more because people think it's a 3DS, and because it's got a cheaper price, they buy it. That increases the sales numbers.
Where are they buying it?
But then don't they return it?
Used?
Yeah, but that doesn't matter. So long as it's...
Well, it does matter because the sale isn't actually a sale.
Yeah, also that's used. I'm talking like straight new. I'm saying like Nintendo cannot make money, until now, could not make money selling Red or Blue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because they don't make DSIs anymore. So if they're buying the, no, they don't. They finish like they don't even
they
make
finally cut it off.
They don't even make normal 3DS. Oh. It's only new 3DS now.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
They don't even make no. They do make 2DSs still. As I say, I thought they might have.
They
cut
have
that.
Yet some variation of it. That's
no, they're not afraid to just stop. They're not like Microsoft, where it's like 4 years later and they're still making 360 games. Like they straight this the day the Switch came out, they were like, we're done with the Wii U. So they've abandoned the DS and 3DS original and all that shit.
Oh, yes. And those were also small as hell. And today a lot of it is about size.
Size matter?
Size does matter.
I
Everything is only game bigger.
The new Nintendo DS?
Mm-hmm. XL or standard?
It only is available in XL in America. And it's honestly...
Damn right.
I don't really care for the size. It's too much. It's an actual issue for me.
I've got one, and I still have yet to open the box, because I'm still super bitter about the whole getting stolen thing. I just haven't been able to bring myself to, like, buy my game. Like, I mean, I've lost, I think, 8 years worth of Pokemon save files in my case of all my games dating back, like, before Diamond. And I lost all the, like, you know, console and all my DS games, all my 3D. Like, I remember that. I cannot bring myself to open up the box and pick up a 3DS game anymore, which sucks because there's so many excellent games.
Yeah.
But it's kind of nice because it's the Majora's Mask Special Edition, so I guess I could sell it eventually.
There's a big problem with that. Is that the new 3DS XL, Majora's Mask?
Yeah, the Majora's Mask one.
You haven't opened it?
No.
So you don't know if it has dead pixels or not? Because
I don't. So
a
I
lot of the special edition 3DSs.
Oh, right, because you're Monster
I bought,
Hunter.
I got two different Monster Hunter 3DSs, both of which had dead pixels. And it was like an alarming number of dead pixels, so I had to return it. And I
was it just the Monster Hunter one, or was it the.
It, as far as I know, it was a lot of the special edition ones.
Huh.
So I'm thinking like there's something about the way that the cases were pressed on there that just killed the screen or something.
That's. Jeez. At least Switches aren't coming out with dead pixels.
Yes, no, they are.
They are. They absolutely are.
So,
and
there
Nintendo's
are so many
response
dead
was,
pixels.
It's not a problem.
We cannot fix it. It's a function of the screen.
Yeah, they literally said that they can't like honor that as a defect because it's not a defect.
That is how it was made.
Beautiful.
They will not refund you anything. So you have
for
to take it
pixels.
Back to the store that you got it from and hope that they accept the return.
So yeah, it does have dead pixels, and they're not handling
Nintendo's
it well.
Doing everything wrong.
They're just hard fucking up right now.
They still think it's the 90s. In
Is
all
the dream
their
of the
practices. 90s
alive within them?
No.
Are they running in the 90s still?
But yeah, it's... Nintendo doesn't know how to step forward.
Yeah, I don't know. They're like I mean, their biggest money or not biggest left. Money maker, but their biggest hype maker last year was the NES Classic.
Yeah.
So they like they literally don't know how to move forward.
I have a question for you.
Switch would have been great stuff.
Do you know off the top of your head how many of those NES Classics they made?
Not enough.
20,000?
Hey.
Okay, I'll look it up right now because
I'm willing to put money on 20K, I guess. That's probably way too few. The Switch had 2 million at launch, so, and even that was hard to get.
There were a lot of extra copies of Switch.
Yeah, that's true.
But right now it might be hard to get, but you could still easily pick one up a week, 2 weeks after launch.
Well, they replenished decently well.
So,
well,
the US
didn't make
got 200,000.
Damn.
Oh well, then that's a shit ton.
That's not a lot.
No, that is not.
For Nintendo?
Nintendo, no. Like I said, the Switch had... Well, you said 200,000? Switch had 10 times that.
200,000? And since then, like since the launch date, they have sold 1.5 million here in the U.S. They launched at 200,000.
Jesus.
Why are so many people buying those?
Because
it's nostalgia.
Pre-programmed with 30 of the classic games. That
it's,
you care about.
Yeah.
You're basically buying an emulator, and you get, what, Donkey Kong?
Donkey Kong! It's the major titles, so it's like Super Mario, Donkey Kong,
Legend of...
LOZ 1 and 2, maybe.
What's the price tag?
$60.
60?
Punch-Out, no. Castlevania. Yeah, it's 60. It's $59.99.
That's okay. No, that is not, yeah, no, well fucking worth it.
Not scalping.
And yeah, no, 1.5 million, that completely, that yeah. They actually appropriately price something.
Yeah, 30 of classic NES games that if you were to actually buy physical copies separately would run you a couple hundred at least.
Mm-hmm. That's... Wow, the classic is the first deal. Good idea they've had in forever.
So,
and it's only a step backwards.
Way
and backwards. One of the better things that it has as well, all the stuff that they've already got pre-programmed on there,
mm-hmm.
you can also connect to the the virtual console and buy more games.
So oh, I didn't know you could put more games on it.
Yeah.
Holy shit. I need to get me one now.
So basically, if the game that you don't want is on there, but that game is on the virtual console, you can get it.
Huh.
But then again, you're going to run the thing of, how many blocks of memory do I have? Well, how much is a block?
That's fucking Nintendo's dumbass block system.
No, it's a great system. You have 40 blocks left in your system. This thing that you're trying to delete is 33 megabytes.
Yep.
That's my favorite thing about Nintendo. Is you try to, like, how much memory do I have left? You have 3,384 blocks. Okay. How much megabytes is that? Oh, don't worry about it. Everything's displayed in blocks.
Don't
you
worry about it.
You go to check it. It's displayed in megabytes. That was, like, the worst thing ever. The GameCube was the only one where it properly worked.
Yo, the GameCube, though. If they did a GameCube classic, I'd be
with,
all
like,
over that.
With, like, such hits as Tales of Symphonia.
Oh, well, not buy a GameCube.
The most expensive game is, like, $60.
It's
no,
only as good as
a non-special edition.
I still have the first Pikmin and Super Mario Sunshine.
Well, you can play it on that GameCube right there. That dusty-ass GameCube.
That is hella dusty.
The hella dusty GameCube.
That GameCube looks like it's dead.
I tried to play Forbidden or Falsebound Kingdom the other day, and my controller
doesn't work. Is that one of
those
Weeaboo games?
It's a Yu-Gi-Oh game. The Yu-Gi-Oh game for the GameCube that's totally the shit. It's totally the shit.
No, the only good Yu-Gi-Oh game outside of Duel Links is the PS1.
Is it, that was just a... Oh, wait. No, wait, which one?
Didn't Zone do a Yu-Gi-Oh game?
Yes, Zone actually made Yu-Gi-Oh. She did the art. I believe that Zone is actually currently drawing a Yu-Gi-Oh hentai. Hopefully, after the great success that was her run on Netflix.
That was a great April Fool's joke.
That was probably my favorite April Fool's joke, hands down. Because I was excited, and I wanted to go back home and watch that.
I was not excited, because I
was
going to
watch the shit out of that. Pants
That's
off
not my
kind
of content.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So,
but
I'm totally straight. I would never look at that kind
of
crap.
Oh, God, no. You know, I'm a respectable man of respectable values.
Your profile picture is Shadman's IQ... Where the ass is just eating the Argentinian woman's ass.
She's nope.
Brazilian.
That's so fucked.
And I don't see your point.
So, going back to it, the thing that's happened with Zone on April Fool's was that Netflix just fucking threw up two different title cards for two different Zone
One
cartoons.
Was like In the Zone, which was like a series featuring Zone 10.
Yeah.
And the other one was a
like
documentary
episode one,
about
she gets
the creator.
Fucked by tentacles.
Probably. That's probably.
Oh,
what
the image
happened.
On
but
the
when you tried
comic
to actually like
good.
Open it up, it wouldn't.
It wasn't top tier, but it was okay.
Do you have Hentai Key or whatever the Zone website is?
Hentai Key,
I do not.
Baby.
I looked at the Tumblr.
Get that April Fool's joke. That Zone 10 Tumblr though.
Yep.
Cannot promote. But
I found it.
Promote.
Is that like Kingdom Hearts
Twitter.
Hentai?
No, Hentai Key is like
Zone's
like you know those like
site.
Those pay for like you'll get access to over 100 different porn sites. It's that but for legit and for hentai and Zone uses it if you want that good.
That good.
That good.
That good tentacle shit.
Oh man. Tentacles though. Why?
Everything has a tentacoral.
Tentacoral.
Tentacore. But no, I mean, so Zone had your favorite April Fool's. That's
hands
your,
down.
That's your number one. What was
it? Got me.
I want to transition over to that. What 2K17, what were the best April Fool's Day pranks? Yours is Zone 10 Netflix.
Zone? Then,
what was your number one comment?
My number one was hands down Elon Musk's chemtrails tweets.
I did not pay much attention to these.
I follow him on Twitter, so I open it up on April 1st, going through my feed, and I see fucking Elon Musk talking about how chemtrails are messages in the sky left by interdimensional aliens teaching us the secrets of time travel.
God.
And I'm just... I don't know how to comprehend this. I figured, is this where it starts? Is this where he starts killing people? But it was an April Fool's joke, thank God. But man, would that be great.
I kind of want conspiracy theory, mad power, Elon Musk.
Yes. It would be so great. That was my hands down number one.
Let me think. If I had to pick mine... Zone is... It might be it. But a close second is the Google Gnome, which was like a YouTube ad that Google put up, which is like basically a Google Home painted blue with a red cone put on top of it. And it's like a smart home, but for the outside. So it created like a smart lawn so you could like turn your hose on and off. And you could
control the speed on your lawnmower.
Yep, you could have it tell you what the weather was or what the time is. Much like a basic clock thermometer outdoors might do.
What's the weather? 76. That's right. It is.
But then I think my favorite part of the ad was like, it was something like, can you turn down the thermostat inside? It's like, sorry, that's an indoor request.
When they asked him to order something for outside, sorry, that sounds like an indoor request.
Yeah, I love that. I want... this little gnome that refuses to help out with indoor-related requests, but will do anything you need it to do to your fucking lawn. I don't know, just, I thought that was pretty damned hilarious. I enjoyed it.
It was a good prank.
Next best one for me, you know, besides Zone, George Takei actually announced that he'd be running for Congress. Because I guess his local... congressman is a sack of shit. So he was like, you know what? I'm gonna do it. And everyone, I believe this. I honestly believe
George Takei?
I was
George
like,
Takei?
Yeah.
Just was shaking like, you know, hands, saying happen. His name.
I really thought it was gonna happen. They ran articles on a couple of websites and everything. And then, like, the next day, he's like, nah. And this is where I loved it. He's like, I'm not. But this guy is, and you should vote for him because our congressman's a piece of shit. And I thought that was awesome. Like, he politicized April Fool's Day without it being, you know, stupid and shitty. He made it like,
for
April
once.
Fool's Day is fun, but also let's put it towards a good cause of getting this piece of shit out of office.
I hate that. I want pieces of shit to only ever be pieces of shit, and I don't want to see pieces of shit used proactively. April Fool's is not for good things.
It's only for porn and Elon Musk.
Only for porn.
Pornhub tried this year. The whole, like, when you opened a video, is like, thanks for sharing.
Oh, geez, yeah.
We've shared this video to all your social media. And that was great, and it did cause legitimate scares. But nothing will ever top Pornhub. It was too
Pornhub was great.
Fucking funny. I can never get past Pornhub.
I never went on for Pornhub.
Wait, it was actually Pornhub?
It was Pornhub.
So, like, all the videos completely were
all the videos were corn.
On the front page, everything was corn videos.
Okay, I thought
if
that
you went deeper, I didn't see you that could one. Actually get to porn.
Okay.
But the front page was nothing but corn videos.
I wanted it to be only corn.
No, that would take so much time and effort to undo later. That's not worth their people's time and money.
I liked, because it didn't seem like a fake announcement when Disney announced a Rogue One sequel.
Rogue Two.
And people were like, oh, holy shit, what are they going to do? And Disney was like, it's all the returning cast, they're all coming back. They're not dead. It's all okay. And people just didn't put it together that it was April.
Yeah.
And there was a bunch of...
all of the people in Rogue One
died.
Kind of... get blown the way
yeah.
the fuck up.
They walked it off. They can walk it off. I got better.
planet disintegrated. I'm okay.
I wouldn't have cared for the joke had people not entirely fallen for it, to be honest. People's reaction to it is what makes me love it.
Did you have any other ones, Michael? There's some about...
There was the CD Projekt Red announcing, "We're making a new statue, guys. We think you're going to like it." And it's just a picture of Geralt in a bathtub.
It wasn't fully nude, but yeah, it was...
It was from the intro to Witcher 3 during the flashback. You see Geralt kind of in a bathtub before he gets crustaceaned, to say the best of it.
Yeah.
And it's basically people were just... I would buy a fucking thing of Geralt.
A lot of people really want to buy it and were mad when it was a joke.
It was honestly... You guys shouldn't have made this into a joke, Joe.
You should have just actually made it.
Yeah, yep. There's actually sufficient demand for that.
So, one that I forgot about, and you guys had these earlier because I bought them, and I'm going to buy more of them, damn it. But Oreos released cookies and cream flavored Oreos.
They're pretty good.
Fun fact about cookies and cream, that is literally what an Oreo is.
Oreo flavored Oreos.
I saw a picture for it like forever ago, and I thought it was a real thing, and I wanted it. And every time we go to the store, I check to see if they've made it, and this time they had, and I swear to God, some shit ran down my pant leg because I was ecstatic. Oh, God. I was just blown away. Oh, right there, geez. Middle of the food aisle, shit everywhere.
Oh man.
And they taste just like a normal Oreo, like a really good normal Oreo, and that's my favorite part. It is exactly what you think it's gonna be, which is just an Oreo that tastes like an Oreo.
They're good.
They're good.
They don't lie about what they are.
I'm not sure if this is an April Fool's Day thing, because they actually made it and put it out, but I think they literally only made them once and we're never going to see them again.
Well, it's a shame. Now we're going to have to go on to eBay or something.
I think this was a really subtle April Fool's Day joke that, like the Geralt. Like, if they had done the tub but only made, like, 100,000 or whatever, 1,000 of
probably
them.
Probably 3,000.
3,000 of them.
And then sold them for like $200 or $300.
Yeah.
It'd
be the equivalent of them doing that, like, it's an April Fool's thing, but you can actually get it. Much like what Cards Against Humanity does. It's an April Fool's thing, but you can actually get it. That's how I feel like this Oreos thing was, but I think there was no publicity around it. And no one's actually aware that these are a thing except, like, me, because I'm way too into them. Buy them. Eat them.
Eat them. Don't hoard them.
It's just a creamy Oreo with a little extra cookie in it.
It's good.
It's good.
Tastes good.
It's just good.
Yes. Yeah.
You can't really say anything other than, it's the best Oreo I've had.
Yeah. The best plain Oreo.
Yeah.
Best plain Oreo.
Didn't Kojima have a thing?
Yes. Fuck him.
What, you're surprised that he did this?
Yes!
How?
I forgot it was April Fool's.
Did you forget it was Kojima?
You got God.
Yeah, no. Like,
yeah, like, come on.
I saw it, like, really early in the morning. I didn't even, like, make the connection, like, oh, March is over. And I just see, hey, you guys, Konami gave me Metal Gear. And I'm just ecstatic. Happy as I fucking can be. And it's just like, haha, April Fool's.
You're
Konami would never
fool.
Give me Metal Gear.
I wish
April Fool's aside.
They'll never do it.
I wish his response had been more, like, headcanon Kojima, where it's just like, haha, JK, Konami would never do that. Fuck them. Fuck them. Fuck them.
Another stupid April Fool's thing was that some makeup lady, some person who does makeup,
didn't wear makeup.
Basically made... up some made someone look like Emma Stone,
okay,
and then stylized them so that it looked like they were coming straight out of God, what's Kojima's new game?
Death Stranding.
So they stylized an Emma Stone lookalike to look like they were in Death Stranding, and it's like, guys, we've got a leak that Emma Stone's gonna be in Death Stranding.
Oh,
so
and
that's a really convoluted.
It's a very convoluted thing
for like the. Maybe 40 people who are still actively following Death Stranding news.
You're looking
there
at
are a lot
of them.
People that are
following
it.
Yeah, no, why aren't people following it?
I'm passively following it.
It looks kind
of
cool.
Because Norman Reedus.
Norman Reedus has got that funny fetus. And basically, God, what was going on? Fuck, I forgot.
So Emma Stone and...
Emma Stone. And now I'm thinking, if enough people like this idea, I think Kojima might put her in.
He might. If he likes her whatsoever, he'd be like, this'll be fun.
Yeah.
Like, I follow his Twitter. He adored La La Land.
We might actually get Emma
Stone.
We
might see Emma Stone in Death Stranding.
Added into Death Stranding.
Did you kill Emma Stone?
Yes. I meant more like the game.
You know,
will
if
come
she actually just got murdered tonight and we released this.
I am
you
number
are,
one suspect.
Yeah,
I
no, that's
that.
Not okay.
This might be the end of the line for Nick.
Hey, it would suck if you did die, Miss Stone, but it'd be really cool if you did, so we went to jail.
I'm just saying, if you send us $300 and you don't die, it's not a coincidence. $350
for tax. We need that. Tax we need to get that tax cover.
Yeah, that LA tax is high.
It's very high.
I don't know that for a fact. I'm sure it's only like 7.5%. But
it's gotta be. I mean, the cost of living there is insane.
It's true.
It's gotta be pretty high.
But you know, what isn't pretty high right now.
Me.
Boats.
Yeah. Right.
Boats.
Boats are not.
Boats
very
are
expensive.
Higher than ever.
No,
the rent.
Water's only rising.
You know, fair enough. Fair
you
enough.
Got you there.
But I see your point. Yes, they are sinking and burning to the bottom of the ocean because...
And by nature of the rule of displacement, the ocean is getting higher because
which
it's
being is raising
filled
ships.
With boats.
Exactly.
We're taking our landmass and throwing it into the ocean. That's just what the ocean wants.
The ocean, you've only made me larger.
What happens when you take stick and break it in two? You have two stick. You
stick
lose wins. Every time. The ocean cannot lose. But, yeah, so a bunch of large, like, an unusually large amount of icebergs are now drifting into shipping lanes.
I like to imagine it's actually someone doing this. Like, they're just intentionally chipping off, like, icebergs.
And
off
just
kind of like land masses and
pushing
them
away.
Off. And he's like, this will be so funny. He's sending it off.
April Fools.
But it, like,
I
he did
people.
It like 8 months ago because
right.
it takes these like icebergs to move.
It wasn't even 8 months ago. It was some guy a decade and a half ago did this. April it, Fools.
One of the icebergs, if you learn.
Well, these are actually happening
April Fools
really fast.
Yeah, no, these
so
are just
it's
like
more
popping
than
up out of fucking nowhere.
400 icebergs. Which is a substantial number.
Is it? Because I don't know much about icebergs, admittedly.
And you're not gonna...
I've seen maybe...
Imagine you've got maybe 3 dozen icebergs drifting into shipping lanes, having to reroute.
How big is it? What quantifies an iceberg?
I don't know if there's an average size of iceberg.
Like, when is it not just ice? When does it become a berg of ice?
When you see it and you understand it can sink you.
When you put a bun and a burger on it.
Yeah.
That's
is that
funny.
It?
Then it's a berg.
You don't
you.
Talk for like 20 minutes.
And that's
what
you go
in on.
Okay. Making me sad, slip slops boy.
God. God. We need a new slip slop.
But experts are wrongly attributing this to strong counterclockwise winds.
It's all about the counterclockwise wind, man.
And perhaps
the counterclockwise wind
also
man
global
wind
warming.
Man.
Maybe global warming, but more than likely, it's these counterclockwise winds.
Oh. Hands down, it's walruses.
If you've ever, you know what?
We are destroying their biome daily, so now they're going to destroy their own biome to kill us to save what's left.
You know they have every right.
They're going like full suicide bomber.
It's
tactics.
About sacrificing some to keep most.
So they're like. You know what? We're all gonna die. Let's kill the humans if we can. Or at the very least, disrupt their trade routes.
So, like, for reference, or for perspective, there were, like, last Monday, there were about 450 icebergs near the Grand Banks of Newfoundland, which no one knows where it is.
Yeah.
Up from 37 a week earlier.
Holy fuck.
You jumped 37 to 450 in a week.
It must be walruses. Nobody else could pump out that many icebergs.
These numbers are not seen until late May or June.
Those are walrus numbers right there.
Oh, yeah. The average right now is about 80. We are seeing 450. That's unprecedented. Ships are having to slow down to a crawl to avoid these. They're having to take detours of hundreds of miles because of all these icebergs coming in, so it's actually a very big issue that's affecting a lot of shipping.
So we send a team in to kill
the walrus.
All the walrus.
Yes.
And then we'll probably stop seeing ice caps melting.
Oh yeah.
Walruses are big. They're hot. They're probably creating heat and melting the ice caps.
They walk around the ocean and leave and rivers. Making it
stronger.
No. Just drink the ocean. If we as a society...
If we just drink enough of the ocean...
Band together and we just drink the ocean...
We can keep it at bay.
Yeah.
Florida won't go underwater in 10 years.
Alternatively, if we could just...
take straws.
Dig it deeper.
Yeah, well, why don't we dig the ocean deeper?
I don't want to drink salt water. We could just go...
We can either dig the ocean deeper or just light it on fire.
Just drill a hole into the mantle and let all the water drain in there.
Just get some more oil mixed in with the water and then light the oil on fire.
That shit's way too hot.
Let's just collapse our planet upon itself.
Be pretty dope.
It would be. It would be a great way to go out. You know, we're talking
about infinite
heat death and the sun killing us. But like, fuck you, sun. We can kill ourselves.
Only by our own hand.
Did you know you're the most likely person to kill yourself? Not if I kill myself first.
I think that's how the planet should go. We're just gonna admit one day that, you know, walruses got the best of us. So we're gonna drill a hole into the core, flood the core, implode the planet.
I'm down.
And we'll take the moon out with us.
Yeah, I was gonna say, is this before or after the moon?
We're gonna have to take out the moon with us. Because I'll be damned if the moon's gonna live longer than me.
Oh god, no.
Me specifically.
Now here's the question. Is there a mech inside the moon just waiting to be freed?
No, this is not a bad MMO that we're trying to restart.
I really hope that
That's a dragon. I'm talking about like Gurren Lagann, where they gotta stab the drill into the face on the moon, and then it turns into a ship capable of sailing the cosmos.
You're using a drill? I thought we were just gonna nuke it.
You never.
We've already got plenty of radiation in space. Nukes don't hurt us. You never pierce
the heavens with your drill?
The moon is not the heavens. The moon is hell.
The moon is confirmed. No, but if
we
break,
we have to bust through hell to get to heaven. Because heaven is a place
on Earth. That's not how that works at all.
We don't know.
Heaven is a place on Earth?
No.
We gotta go from space through the moon into the Earth.
Think about it. We don't know what's slow down, Kaiba. On the other side of the moon. If we just go through the moon with a drill, pop out on the other side, see what's over there, blow up the moon.
We could put a giant stick in it and it can be one of those cake pops.
Or we could try to give it a like proctology exam or something. We could
spin the stick.
So we're no longer destroying the moon, we're just putting it on a stick.
We're just diddling the moon now.
We're going to fuck up its orbit so bad that the tides are going to go all wonko and we're going to spin it away from us. Like, so, when you throw a bowling ball in the lane, but you give it a spin so it slowly just kind of goes down, spiraling. Yeah. We're going to do that to the moon and send it straight to the sun.
We're going to fuck the moon.
No. It's not a phallic pole.
It's a very, very platonic pole.
Yes.
How?
It doesn't have veins.
Multiple segments.
That doesn't make it any better. If anything,
what penis has multiple segments?
It droops, and then you have to make the pole erect.
No, it's not drooping at all. It's you put in one piece, and you spin it around, and you put in the other, and you lock it in, and you put in the next, and it's like Tetris.
So in other words, at rest, it's flaccid.
No.
It's not, they're different pieces. It's not one entity.
They're not like chained together with like, you know,
so they're like tent poles.
At worst, it's anal beads.
It's like tent poles, except they're never not erect.
Oh, God.
Never not erect platonic poles. For the moon.
We've got...
It's simple.
How much nickel do we have? We could just do that.
We can just make this.
We can use our three Olympic swimming pools of gold and make it entirely out of gold.
We'll turn the Earth...
You ever hear those facts about how if we take every single trash
landfill?
Thing, yeah, landfill. Well, let's just use landfill.
We could actually, yeah.
We just don't.
We have enough trash to get to the moon and back.
We have enough trash that we can just blow up the moon.
That is doable.
We're gonna trash the moon.
Yeah.
Hashtag trash the moon.
Hashtag trash the moon.
Party of the century.
We just load up a rocket with all of our trash,
send it to the moon.
Shoot it at the moon, and then it's gonna, like, bounce the moon out of orbit and away from us.
If it doesn't work the first time, we do it again.
Yeah.
We'll just keep sending trash at the moon
until we've got enough trash. We'll certainly make enough trash.
I think we're just going to create a Saturn-like ring around us.
We already have worse than... Like, it's not to the level of Saturn, because it's not particular.
It's nowhere near.
But we do have a ring. Not really a ring, but a cloud around Earth.
It's a small cloud, yeah. No,
it's not very significant.
It is incredibly small.
No, it is...
In perspective.
In perspective, yeah.
Yes.
We can't see it.
Yeah.
But...
It's not there.
You know what else we can't see? Oxygen.
It's there. Not there.
We can definitely see oxygen.
What's your argument?
If we couldn't see it, it wouldn't be there.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Therefore, it must be there.
If I can't see it, it don't exist.
If there was no oxygen between my eye and that printer, I would be perceiving it differently. Which means I am seeing the oxygen and it is altering my perspective.
I'm on board with this.
You know,
I can see oxygen.
You can see oxygen, I can't see slavery.
It doesn't,
doesn't exist.
Ever.
They are Nicaraguan volunteers.
They're just really, really pushed by their managers. They have high expectations for them.
Oh, yes.
I can't see the physical embodiment of the law, so it doesn't exist.
I don't pay the cop taxes. I pay the other taxes.
Can I choose not to pay this one tax?
Yes.
Good.
Yeah.
I'm going to choose not to pay any tax.
It's great. Well.
It's still going if you...
You hit it. It did not seem... Well, that's it for the Moisty Voice episode 6. We kept it nice and tight today.
The 6th thing.
Only an hour. Which is down from our hour 20, hour 30, whatever it was.
Yeah.
Getting better.
This is for you, Brick. Mm-hmm.
This one's for you, Brick.
We cater to one fan a little too much.
As always, please go to bad-dragon.com and buy their products as bad-dragon.com. They sell handmade quality home ornaments, you know, kitchen utensils kind of stuff.
They also sell this one thing that looks like a flexed bicep with a penis tip at
it will
the
kill
end
you.
Of it. It's intense. It's three soda cans wide.
You can't fit that.
You can't.
There isn't that much room between your hip bones.
But, yeah, so visit them, mention us, and stay
moist. Moist 13.
Moist 13.
Gets you 11% off.